This is Rochester, New York, a diverse and engaged city with a deep history of being on the front lines in the fight for social justice, fair treatment, and equality for all Americans. Like many other American cities, our community faces concentrated poverty that is disproportionately defined by race. However, the difference between Rochester and many other cities is how our community has embraced its great legacy and band together to find creative and inclusive approaches to improving disparities in our city.
Rochester has recently adopted a new 15-year comprehensive plan in which social and economic equity plays a central role in guiding the city's future development. It embraces the fact that sustainable economic growth cannot happen if the health and security of everyone in every neighborhood is in doubt.
Our nation is gripped by a worldwide pandemic and social upheaval. Rochester has managed to meet these challenges head on through the very same spirit of collaboration.
Rochester is known as the city of volunteers for good reason. Our citizens are resilient and have a sincere desire to make a difference and to be the change that they are seeking in their neighborhoods.
Collaboration among Rochester's residents is our greatest strength. It drives our city's progress, innovation, and economic development.
Today, we will share three community grassroots projects that have improved the health of our community through active community partnerships that expand out into the neighborhoods. We stand together.
Rochester strong.
Rock forward.
We stand together, Rochester strong, rock solid. Our first story is the innovative work of the High Blood Pressure Collaborative, who took the lead in pioneering a community-driven approach to lowering blood pressure, collaborating with business, the medical community, faith organizations, and grassroots leaders to invest in the health of an entire community. After a decade of collective action, blood pressure control in the region increased from 71 to 82%, improving daily life for thousands of our residents and saving the lives of so many more. The collaborative trained residents, faith leaders, barbers, and stylists as community health educators and conducted over 3,000 blood pressure screenings, improving the health of our Black and Brown communities.
Hey, Miss Jackie, it's so good to have you back. Mm-hmm. I fell out when you called me and said, it's head looking a mess. But go ahead, catch me up. Girl. How are you?
Besides my hair stressing me out, everybody is okay. Thank God. My faith has kept me strong enough to do what I need to do for my family.
Yeah, but what about you? You know that self-care is so essential for your health first. As ladies and caregivers, we forget about ourselves way too much.
You're right about that, and I've been guilty for that for far too long. Mm-hmm. Sometimes my head be killing me, and my heart be racing so fast after dealing with so many of my family issues.
See, that is classic signs of high blood pressure and stress. Do you keep track of your blood pressure numbers?
No, I never really think about it. I just keep it moving.
Well, as a community health educator, I provide high blood pressure screenings right here, meeting people where they are. We call it wash, rinse, and blood pressure check.
Really? That's right. I didn't realize I was doing all that. Mm-hmm. Well, you know my family's history. Mm-hmm. We need to end this generational curse so our children and grandchildren can live healthier, longer lives.
I hear you, sis. And that's why we have to feed our people resources and knowledge, including our Spanish community. Mm-hmm. Our people perish because of lack of knowledge. We are dying way before our time. Mm-hmm. And this pandemic is shedding even more light on these health inequities.
That's right.
But today
that's
is your lucky day. I'm doing blood pressure right now.
Now that's what I'm talking about, girl. This is awesome. I'm going to get my family to come and get their blood pressure checked. We sure need this.
Yes, ma'am. Mm-hmm. We got to help take care of one another.
That's right.
Even the churches have been in the high blood pressure.
Yeah, my church.
Yeah, I'm telling you. They give exercise classes, nutrition classes, everything. All right, let me check your numbers. All right, 122/78.
I tell you, God knows what you need. He's an on-time God.
Well, you know the song we sang. He's an on-time God.
Yes, he is.
The Ibero-American Development Corporation has invested and collaborated on many projects in the diverse and economically challenged El Camino neighborhood. Among several efforts, Ibero spearheaded Project Hope, funded by the Greater Rochester Health Foundation, to improve the overall health and well-being of the El Camino area. In El Camino, residents drive solutions. creating new parks, trails, and a vision plan that has brought forth new development. Come take a stroll through the El Camino neighborhood as one resident shares her story across generations.
Manichon, mamita. It's so cool to see you sitting outside enjoying the view. I remember when you didn't even let me go outside.
I'm so glad you came to see me today. It's been a while, and that's because the neighborhood wasn't safe, but so much has changed. You know, this used to be my parents' house, and your mom and aunt grew up here.
I know. You tell me that every time. Let's take a walk. Tell me what's going on. I see a lot of new things happening.
Yes, let's start with El Camino Trail. You know, Project Hope helped neighbors organize and advocate for better neighborhoods and a safer place to live. I remember where you were only 5 years old when you did your first 5K walk.
I remember. I also remember the first children's event at the Cherry Street Garden. We watched the Chose movie.
Yes, mothers organized and campaigned and made that garden a better place. It used to be infested with drugs and activities, and now it's so much more. They do karate classes, food distribution, Zumba classes.
Mamita, look, I remember you led the first Namas with over 120 people. It's great to see people are working together to make sure the neighborhood is safe. Let's walk to La Margueta next. I would love to see this 40-year dream come true.
Yes, 40 years in the making, but we didn't give up and we did it together. And now we have this beautiful plaza where we can shop, have events, gathered, and it's surrounded by a $38 million housing development. And I can see it from my front yard.
You and all the other residents should be so proud.
Yes, Tashi, I'm glad you see our efforts. It takes a lot of hard work and dedication. I want you to be an active citizen of this Flower City. And I want this house to be in our family for generations to come.
Thanks, Mamita. I know how important your work is to this neighborhood. I feel fortunate that this community is going to leave a better place for me and Jason and our generations to come. Our future looks bright here because all the work you put in today.
Yes, and we did it from the bottom up. We didn't push neighbors out, and we get to stay and enjoy our work.
Racism is a public health crisis. We stand together, Rochester strong, rock forward. Across the U.S., Black and brown children are being pushed out of school, ignoring and damaging their social-emotional health. Can you imagine? In a single year, our students were being suspended nearly 55,000 days of school due to being suspended. 88% of those suspensions were for nonviolent behaviors. And up until 2014, virtually none of the problems that led to the behaviors were ever solved.
Answer me this. Why? Have a building full of staff with master's degrees and none of them can relate to me? Our schools could be full of love and care inside these four walls, but instead, traumatized kids can easily go to jail for fighting in the halls. No money for textbooks, but money for scanners. No money for decent food to eat, but there was police in our schools. No money for more student counselors, but there are security guards all around us. We have refused to be blinded to the fact that something drastically needs to change.
We showed up, we organized, and we altered the power dynamics to change policy. Solutions, not suspension. We implemented, we evaluated, and we kept fighting for more change.
Please understand, being restorative isn't just a brand. It takes practice and patience. Us students are waiting, and it is time. Time that we are valued for who we are. Time for us to see ourselves in the classroom and the curriculum. Time for us to be represented. And we strive for solutions, not suspensions. It is time that we pay attention to the minds of students because for a long time, it is not something that we were doing. We know the problem, and now we're getting to it.
The impact, you ask? Over a five-year period, suspensions dropped by 33%, and in turn, course completion increased by 28%, meaning that more students are earning their credits, and our graduation rate has improved 20%.
We made history at the University of New York State that removed these from schools. We are reimagining safety in the beloved school community. We continue together fighting for racial equity in the social and emotional health for everyone.
Our community forebearer and Rochester resident, Frederick Douglass, once said, if there is no struggle, there is no progress. And in Rochester, we certainly had our share of struggles, but these days we're making progress. We're making progress and making our community stronger and better. And you just stop. It's through innovation, combating racism as a public health crisis. It's through engagement and empowerment, making sure that citizens have the opportunity to envision and then implement the changes they want to see. And it's through collaboration, bringing together the unusual stakeholders, everyday residents, along with community leaders and business leaders, to bring about a more equitable, fair, and vibrant process for generations to come. Thank you for allowing us to share our story. Our story for Rochester our story for Rochester as it gets stronger. Rochester strong, Rochester!